This video is brought to you by Vita Bee Health. A great society is built from skilled people performing specific tasks to keep a functioning society. Mastering a language is an important skill to have. By doing so, you can learn more sophisticated skills faster and with greater precision. However, a language is not innate in our DNA. A language is something we have to learn from other members of the society. This is called social learning. Honeybees, one of the most successful societies in natural history, are known for their capability to communicate with other colony members, a phenomenon discovered by Dr. Carl von Frisch, Nobel Prize winner in 1973. Dr. Frisch showed that forager bees are able to go outside the colony, look for food, memorize the location and quality of the food source, come back to the colony and translate the findings into a series of movements that can be understood by other colony members. And this way, they can go after the precious food source with precision without spending any time searching for it. A dance that became known as the Waggle dance. The Waggle dance is a mini-map of the food location and contains three critical information. The direction of the Waggle gives the direction of the food source, the duration of the Waggle indicates how far the food source is, and the repetition of the dance indicates how good the food source is. In a honeybee society, honeybee workers use social learning when they are following the Waggle dance to learn resources, location, and quality. There are two separate skills involved in Waggle dance communication. 1. The ability to read the code and locate the food source, and 2. The ability to write the code and communicate it to the other members of the colony. It is unclear whether writing the code is a skill learned from older, more experienced bees, or if it is completely innate to each individual and it will happen regardless. To investigate that, researchers compared Waggle dance behavior of forager bees from two different groups of colonies. Same age colonies, where researchers built artificial colonies consisting only of same age bees, and in these colonies, new forager bees never come in contact with older, more experienced bees. And number two, control colonies. These are normal mixed age colonies with a variety of individuals. Here, young bees can follow and perhaps learn things from older bees. Once the colonies were set up, the researchers also set up food resources at identical distances and direction from each colony, so they could measure potential errors in the Waggle dance between the two groups. Normal forager bees, who have practiced the dance several times in the presence of older bees, make an average error of around 25 degrees from the correct direction of the food source. While first dancers from the same normal colonies that also had the chance to interact with older bees were a little worse than the previous ones with more practice, having an average error of 30 degrees. But things got very intriguing when researchers look at foragers from same age colonies. The researchers found that the first dancers from same age colonies, bees that never had the opportunity to interact with older, more experienced bees, were very bad at delivering the correct information. They had an average error of almost 40 degrees when trying to dance for the first time. Some bees were so bad that they delivered a 65 degrees error. However, they got better with time and reduced the error to around the same level as normal colonies, indicating that the Waggle dance directional error was highest in the first dances of naive bees that could not follow experienced Waggle dancers. Interestingly, errors were also found when researchers measured food distance, food quality, and dance quality as well. Just as modern societies depend on successful educational systems to stay ahead and functional, honeybees might have also evolved a full educational system that had yet to be fully comprehended. And I asked Dr. James Nieh from the University of California in San Diego a little bit more about this fascinating research.
So here we see the image of the Waggle dancer in the middle and the dance followers that are following it. And here's a video actually showing the bee in the center. It's got the white-orange dot on its back, and it's being followed by other bees. So this is the classic Waggle dance. Now notice that the angle the bee is moving when it's waggling. It's about, I would say, 20 degrees to the left of the vertical position. Here's an example of another Waggle dance, and they're all pointing in the same direction because they're all being trained and indicating the same food location. Now, these are pretty good waggle dances. Notice that each time she's more or less pointed in the correct direction. The duration of the waggle run communicates food distance. The farther away the food, the longer the waggle run. The direction, as I just said, points to the direction of the food relative to the sun. Now you see other dancers, and notice they're all pointed in about the same direction. Some of them are not exactly in the same direction. This green one is making some errors, but overall, on average, they're pointing in the correct direction. Now, in this experiment, we found that novices are able to learn how to dance better from observing other waggle dancers. And you can see there are a lot of painted bees here. These are all the bees that we were training and following in our experiment. And this is a fun thing because there's a lot going on, so it's good that people can train themselves on looking for the other dancers. So I wanted to mention the amount of time that they should waggle to communicate distance. As I said, if they do it incorrectly or learn somehow incorrectly when they're young, it appears to persist for their entire lifespan. And this could be a form of cultural transmission. In other words, maybe one generation will teach the next the incorrect distance encoding. And I'll go over that in a moment. But another reason that maybe bees need to learn is look at the dance floor. So some bees are dancing on this brood comb that's covered with this fluffy wax. Some bees are dancing on the open comb. We know that the dance surface influences the accuracy of the dance. So is it possible by practicing, by dancing on these different surfaces, that they are actually learning to dance better over time? That's something, that's an experiment that we hope to work and explore in greater detail.
The article was published in the prestigious journal Science. It is a must read to everyone. But wait, there is a little problem. The paper is behind a paywall. How delightful. Thank you, prestigious science journal. Anyhow, the first author, a true gentleman, has made the article available to everybody on the ResearchGate website. The link is provided in the description of this video. Thank you, Dr. Dong. There are many implications regarding these findings. For example,
do you think pesticides might be damaging their learning abilities or other things that may perhaps the regulatory system are not being able to catch?
That's a great point. So the regulation is based largely upon studies of mortality. Do bees die or not within 48 hours or so of being treated with a pesticide? But there are long-term effects on survival that we know. But whether you live or die is a very, very coarse way of looking at it because bees need to communicate and they have a lot of sophisticated behaviors. Work that I have done with colleagues in my lab and with students has shown that there are multiple effects on bee behaviors, their ability to walk, their ability to dance, and their ability to learn. So many researchers have now shown that when bees, and these could be stingless bees, or it could be honeybees, or even other kinds of bees, when they receive sublethal doses of pesticides, meaning they're not dying right away, their cognition is impaired. They have a reduced ability to learn, and they have reduced memory. And this can happen at any life stage. For example, larvae that are fed food by nurse bees that's contaminated with pesticides, when they become adults, they can also have poorer learning. So in many ways, for example, we talk about lead and the effects of lead on human children. When they grow up, it actually reduces their IQ, reduces their ability to learn, very similar to the problem with pesticides.
If you want to know more about this research, I interview Dr. Nieh in my podcast. The episode is already available to everybody, and I encourage you to check it out. Thank you very much, Dr. Nieh, for your time. Your research is inspiring. Please keep doing the things you do. We appreciate it. I would like to thank my patrons for the support. Without you guys, I couldn't do what I do. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you for the support. So, and you at home, if you enjoy this kind of content, if you want me to bring more research about honeybees, please consider to join our community. It's a lot of fun and you guys can get a lot of different stuff. Visit patreon.com/insidethehivetv for more information. Another way to support me is to support the sponsors of this video. I would like to thank Vita Bee Health for sponsoring this video. Vita, thank you for the support. Please check them out, link in the description of this video. So if you have some extra time, I encourage you to check this video right here to learn more about bees, because that's what we do here. Thanks for watching Inside The Hive TV, the show about bees. See you guys next week.